Pokemon!
Hello guys, so today we're doing lesson 3.5, which is laws of logarithms. Now there's four you need to know. First one is we'll be discussing is the change of base law. Second one is the product law. Third one is the quotient law. And the last one is the power law. So the first law we're going to discuss is called the change of base law. Now what the change of base law tells you is if we have log of base A of B, that is equivalent to log of base C of B over log of base C of A. Now you're probably wondering what that C is since it wasn't involved here. That is really, it's a number that you can kind of make up on your own. Usually you stick to 10 because of your calculator. Your calculator is always has a base 10 whenever you input log for most calculators. But this is something, this formula is something you do want to remember. Now, a quick example of this is if we're evaluating log of base 7 of 5, log of base 5 of 9, times log of base 9 of 7. Again, it really doesn't matter how which number you pick for C. You can always assume it's going to be 10. So you can manipulate this as saying log of base 5. And log of base 7 times log of base 9 over log of base 5 and log of base 7 over log 7 and log 9. Again, I did not write my my base. You can always assume that is 10. What happens here is, as you can see, log of base 5, log of base 5, they cancel out log of base 9, log 7, and log 7. They all end up canceling out. You're going to end up with 1 here. So this is a quick exercise just to get you involved in how to set those up. Alright, so the next thing we have is called the product law. What the product law tells you is log base of A, X, Y. And we can basically split this up, since these share the same base. Into log of base A X plus log of base A and Y. So you should be able to go back and forth between these two, given the fact that you have the same base. Now again, some quick examples of what the product law tells you is, I know 7x shares the same base, so I can simply say, well, log of base 3 times 7 plus log of base 3 times x. So for example number 2, now for the first example, we went from, it was a condensed form, we went to the expanded form. This is the expanded form, we want to make it into a condensed form. Now since they share the same base of 6, we can say log of base 6 and then 3 and 2, which are factors here. So 3 times 2, all right? We're still not done yet. We can simplify this a bit further. So log of 6 of 6. Now, based upon the videos that you've been watching and what you've been doing in class, you should know that this is equal to 1. All right, so the third law we have is called the quotient law. Now let's read what the quotient law tells us. So quotient law says, well, log of base A, x over y, x divided by y, that can be split up into log of base A, x minus log of base A and y. Now again, same thing applies. You should be able to go back and forth between the condensed form and the expanded form. Now let's go ahead and do two examples. This is a condensed form, we're going to make it into expanded form. Now again, I should be able to, since both of these have the base of 2, these factors of base of 2, this should be log base of 2 and then x plus 1, It is division, so you are going to subtract. You are going to say log of base 2 times x. All right? So when it comes to example 2, we have the expanded form. We are going to condense it, meaning make it smaller, into using the quotient law. Now what we have here is, you got to notice, we do have subtraction. We do have the same bases, so we can go ahead and put this in this form. So we have log 2 of x to the 4th power over x to the 3rd power. Now we can keep going with this. What we'll end up with is log of base 2 of x. Alright, so the next thing we have up is something you're familiar with, something that was introduced to you a couple videos ago. It's called the power law. And again, what the power law tells you is if we have log of base a, x to the r power, what we can simply do is take our exponent, put it in front of our log, which you have done so in on the right side. And that helps quite a bit. It is a very essential tool that you'll use throughout this unit. As far as these examples go, I'll kind of run through these pretty quickly. I'll try to. So we have log of base 5. What I'm going to do with this guy, well, we should be able to represent these in exponent form. So that's 5 to the 1/2 power. Now, again, please do remember your power law. What we can do to your exponent, put it back in front of your log, and we have log, 1/2 log of base 5. And this should be pretty familiar to you guys at this point. Log of base 5, 5 is going to be 1, and 1 times 1/2 is going to be 1/2. All right, so for our second example, we have log of base a, 8 divided by log of base a, 4. Now, it might not come to you quickly when you do see this problem isolated from what we're talking about right now, but we can change this up where we can use the power law. Now, we can go ahead and say log of base a, we can change that to, let's say 2 to the 3rd, and we have log of base a, let's change that to 2 to the 2nd power. So we'll take advantage of the power law here. So this comes out to be, well, again, that 3 comes in front, this 2 comes in front. What we have here is 3 log base a, 2. And what we have here is 2 log base a of 2. And again, these will cancel out. Log of base a2, log of base a2, they will cancel out. So what you end up here is just 3 over 2. All right, a quick example that will show you a lot of the laws that we've have talked about in this video as well as before. The question is, express 3 plus log of base 2, 5 as a single log. Now the first place you do want to start is with this 3, and I would put it into log formation. Now if you're probably wondering how you want to do that, now since we're already dealing with log base of 2, and you should be able to remember that log base of 2 is just 1. Well, how can I get 3 from that? I can simply say 3 times log of base 2 of 2 is 3. And have log of base 2, 5. All right, the next thing I can do is, since my goal is to have a one single log, is to basically have used the power rule, right? Now, we've used it in, we're gonna use it a bit in reverse here. So we can say, this would be essentially log of base of 2, and then 2 to the 3rd power plus log base of 2, and 5. So we, in this example, from here to here, we use the power law. Now let's go ahead and simplify here, since we have 2 to the third power here. Let's go ahead and say log of base 2, that would be 8, plus log of base 2, 5. And this should ring a bell, because I know I have the same bases, I have a addition sign, right? What we can do here is basically use the product law. And when I say product law, again, this is an expanded form. I can go ahead and say, I put this in condensed form, where I can say log of base 2. Again, that addition sign is important, because when it comes to logs, that would be 8 times 5. And I would end up having log of base 2 and 40. Now having this, I can keep on going further. I can use my change of base law in just a second, because I can rewrite this as log of 40 over log of 2. Log of 40 and log of, over log of 2 is going to end up being 5.3. So notice how we kind of went from one step to the other. You do have to know these laws. They're nice tools to have when you go from step to step.